Good afternoon. Who's ready to lead a pilgrimage? Oh, I don't want to. It's too much work is usually the first response. My name is Deacon Kevin Bagley. I am living and working in Fort Worth, Texas. I've been doing pilgrimages for about 10 or 12 years now. First pilgrimage was a small group of us that went to Rome back about 2006. The last few pilgrimages I've done with Select International, the same group that Deacon mentioned earlier. So just some quick thoughts. First and foremost, what is a pilgrimage? Well, a pilgrimage is an opportunity for us to get in touch with the Lord. Pilgrimages have been going on for decades, centuries, eons. Folks looking for an opportunity to get closer to God in their faith and understand more about certain places. Some of the images that you see on this slideshow are those that we took last month. We finished a pilgrimage that started in Paris, went to Lourdes, and then ended in Fatima. So as we look through these, it's an opportunity to travel together with a bunch of folks, right? The request of the deacons here and their wives is to think about leading a pilgrimage. Now, what all does that mean? It's nothing like you think. It's a lot of fun, first and foremost. It's an opportunity to pray, reflect, and be with parishioners, friends, well, anyone that sees the brochure, actually. Here we are in Lourdes. We took, there were 28 of us that went on that trip, including one of our priests. So what all is entailed, right? A lot of fun, like I said. Select International will take care of everything. You make a call, you talk to Adita Keurig, the president of Select International. Adita has been, let me get to her slide there. Just more stuff about, I'll come back to a couple of these images. But let's start with the most important stuff first. Who are you going to talk to and who's in? There we go. One more. There it is. So Adita's a well-known travel expert. She's been doing this for a lot of years. She is a devout Catholic and wants to make sure that Catholic pilgrimage is Catholic. Many of the places you're going to go are, of course, tourist destinations. And there will be the opportunity during any Select International tour to see some of the fine art and museums and places that the pilgrims would go and visit. But most importantly, it's a prayer experience. So as we look at what could be happening, right? So you talk to Adita and you decide where you want to go. On the back of the program, if you scan that QR code, it'll take you to a site that speaks a little bit about deacons leading pilgrimages. Your first conversation is either going to be with Adita or Matt. And the question is going to be, where do you want to go? What do you want to see? Now, the whole world out there to explore. If you also visit on the Select International page, you can look at all of the different pilgrimages that are already scheduled. I have taken pilgrimages to the Holy Land, to Italy, and now to Fatima, Lourdes, and Paris. A couple of those have been repeat visits. Find out where you want to go. What do you want to see? Contact Select. Now, many of you probably booked your own hotel for this voyage. How many hotel rooms do you think you need to book to lead a pilgrimage? None. How many airline reservations do you need to make? None. How many itineraries do you need to schedule? None. What? This is too easy. It is. The whole idea is that you leading a pilgrimage is to get a couple of dozen folks to go with you someplace that they all want to go. And by getting the group together, the benefit for you is that you don't have to pay for the trip. With every 10, and again, this is a contract negotiation between you and Adita, depending on the trip, the length, and the things you're going to see. There's usually one free ticket for every 10 paid pilgrims. With a deacon going, you need 10 other souls. A deacon and wife, you need 20 other souls. And this is where it gets rather interesting as a deacon trying to lead a pilgrimage, because we'd like to bring a priest along. That's 10 more people. The magic number is 30, deacon, wife, and priest. Now, we went to Fatima, we had 28. It cost us some out-of-pocket money. Well, for what we experienced, the $1,500 we had to pay for both of us for 12 days in international travel and first-class hotels, motor coach, and all the rest, including tips, wasn't too bad. I think I may be spending more money on this trip. Just me. So the whole idea is, if you can be an ambassador for some place that you want to go, to be able to gather a group of people, Select will take care of all the printing of all the materials, all the logistics, all the everything. You need to be the voice. You need to put your voice, your desire, your experience, your passion for learning more about the faith, for experiencing the sacred sites, for a willingness to just gather people to go. Your tour guide, experienced professional tour guide, will meet you at the airport with a really nifty red Select International sign. See if I can find that sign for you. I know there was one of us. There we are. There's Teresa up front with a Select International flag. She met us at baggage claim, took us to the airport, and was with us every single minute. When we get to certain places, we had a professional tour guide in Lourdes. We had a professional tour guide in Fatima. We had a professional tour guide in Paris. They know all the answers to all the questions. So when was the cornerstone put in that building? These folks have got a doctorate in the material that they are talking about. You're there as a spiritual guide, along with the pastor or the priest, whoever you're bringing with you. I led the rosary dozens of times. On this most recent trip, I had the privilege, because our Select guides know what they're doing and who to talk to, I led a decade of the rosary in Lourdes and in Fatima. In Fatima before the candlelight procession, I had the opportunity to preach at the side altar at the Chapel of Apparitions in Fatima. I had the opportunity on the Rome trip to preach at the chapel adjacent to the tomb of St. Peter. It's a wonderful opportunity to see the world, to do things you might not have been able to do. And I know Deacon Greg said earlier, you know, sometimes we are so unappreciated. Well, you know, that all comes full circle when you are standing 12 feet away from the miracle in L'Annunziata, where the Eucharist bled, and being able to preach. It's a gift. It's those kinds of things that you can't imagine you were ever able to do. Try keeping a straight face when you are at Lourdes looking up at the statue of Our Lady as you're leading a decade of the rosary. Tell me it's not a graced and wonderful life that we lead. So the opportunity is yours. The world is yours. It's an opportunity to see and go places you haven't been before. Do you need to be an expert on the field in which you're in the area you're going? You do not. Do you need to make hotel reservations? You do not. Do you need to make airplane reservations? You do not. Logistics amount to next to nothing, because Select International takes care of everything. What I choose to do is, 3 months before the pilgrimage begins, we have our very first pilgrims meeting. Now, there will have been advertising 12 to 15 months before that. So right now, I'm planning the trip to Italy in 2025, giving folks lots of time. A pilgrimage is about $4,000. Now, do you know the main difference between pilgrims and tourists? And this is one of the things I really focus in on all my meetings. What's the difference between a pilgrim and a tourist? Pilgrims don't complain. I set that as the cornerstone of all of our meetings. But I do a PowerPoint at each one of the 3 meetings. They're about a month apart, building anticipation and excitement for the travel. I take about a third of each of the pilgrimages and cover it on each day. So as we're going through, let me run ahead just to some of the images from the most recent one. And I'll use these images next time. You know, I'm in procession at Sunday Mass in Fatima. What does our tour guide do the night before? They write up our itinerary. What are we going to do tomorrow? Where are we going? You recognize Fatima, the shrine there. There were a couple of anniversaries on the last trip, so we celebrated anniversaries as well. Did I do anything? No, I mentioned it to the tour guide. She talked to the maid of D. They got a candle and a cake. We're in Avila. We spent a few hours in Avila. There we are at the Basilica in Avila. There was another deacon that went on this trip, two deacons on the one before that. We all take turns preaching. Lourdes at the grotto. From atop the basilica, looking out, there's a side view of the basilica with the grotto in the front right corner. The water experience in Lourdes, you no longer go into the baths. There's a different water experience. Water is poured on your hands, splashed on your face, drink some of the water. A few of our folks volunteered to help. They were candle bearers in the candlelight procession in Lourdes. Visiting the home of Bernadette Subaru. Took the high-speed train from Paris south. It slowed down at that point. I didn't get there fast enough. Just 170 miles an hour on the bullet train. The cathedral in Chartres. There's Saint Bernadette. Notre Dame in Paris. The Eiffel Tower. This is us getting ready to go. One group photo in Dallas-Fort Worth at the airport. Our Italy trip, there we were getting ready to go here, Orvieto. The cloth from the miracle in Orvieto, where while saying Mass, the Austrian priest noticed that the host began to bleed. That answered his doubts as to whether or not there is a real presence in the Eucharist. It was one of the very first Eucharistic processions. Pope came to Orvieto, held up that corporal, and walked it through town to say, yes, the Eucharist is real, the real presence of Jesus Christ. Again, different tour guide, different place. Here's what we're doing tomorrow. Assisi, saying Mass at the tomb of St. Francis, Deacon Umberto was present and was able to preach at that Mass. St. Clair's Chapel, where the San Damiano cross is. Here I am, this is in Lanciato. On the other side of that glass, right behind the main altar, is where the miracle resides. There it is there. St. Padre Pio's church. And there's Padre Pio. His confessional. This is the underground grotto of St. Michael on the eastern coast of Italy. A grotto founded by a farmer who shot an arrow into a cave trying to get his cattle to come out. The arrow went into the cave, turned around, came back, and hit him in the leg. St. Michael said, "This is my grotto." Church has been held there every day. Visiting the home of St. Maria Goretti and the place where she was stabbed. St. Stephen's Chapel in St. Paul Outside the Walls. There we are in front of St. Peter's Basilica. Giorgio, the tour guide. The distinctive Select International flag. Deacon Mike Handler at another chapel. Here I am, right behind us is St. Peter's tomb. The opportunities are immense, the opportunities are wonderful, the opportunities are just unbelievable. No cost, no obligation to call, to talk to Matt, to talk to Adita, to see what you can arrange. Again, the challenge bringing a priest along with you is it takes 10 more folks. Now, I did the travel to Italy without a priest. The beauty there is there are lots of American-speaking priests in Rome, lots to be found in Assisi, especially our pastor is a Franciscan friar, Third Order regular. So he had some connections. One of the Franciscans from Assisi met us in Orvieto. The priest in Lanciato didn't speak much English at all. That's okay, we did the readings in English. He said the rest of the mass in Italian, and I preached in what I thought was English. So if you've got any questions, I'm here the rest of the time. Again, just scan the QR code on the back of the brochure. That'll put you in touch with Matt. Look at the Select International website for different locations and different pilgrimages that you can lead. And again, the leading part is really getting 20 or 30 folks together to take the same trip. And when you do that, again, for every 10 paying passengers, one individual goes free. So with or without a priest, Select International was very good about trying to get us priests where we didn't have one. On the trip to Italy, it was 11 days. We had mass 9 out of the 11 days. So they were very, very helpful. So if you've got any questions, I'll be around. Please feel free to reach out, and thank you very much for your time. Mm-hmm.